Hello there, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to get started as a WordPress contributor. WordPress is open source. This means that this website building software is free for anyone to use, modify, build upon, and redistribute without a fee. People all over the world use WordPress for reasons big and small. The global team of WordPress contributors makes the WordPress open source project free and effective for all. In this video, we'll discuss the goals behind being a WordPress contributor, the five main types of contributing, and some tips for first-time contributors. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, the goals of being a WordPress contributor. Here are a few public mantras that will give you an idea about the end goal of contributing. First, there's the WordPress philosophy based on the four freedoms of open source. The freedom to run the program for any purpose. The freedom to study how the program works. The freedom to change the program to make it do what you wish. And the freedom to distribute copies of your modified versions to others. We contribute because it enables us to ensure these freedoms. Remember that these freedoms apply to almost any open source project, not just WordPress. As a contributor, you'll also want to learn a bit of Five for the Future. This initiative, launched in 2014, encourages organizations and individuals to contribute 5% of their resources to WordPress development. When you participate in Five for the Future by dedicating your time to the WordPress open source project, you promote the four freedoms, identify and recruit new talent, influence the direction of the WordPress technology, and contribute to the future of the open web. The four freedoms gives you the philosophy, and the five for the future gives you a plan. Hopefully by now you're thinking, how can I begin contributing? What can I do? Where do I start? Luckily, since much of the WordPress world is online, it's easier than ever for you to connect with contributing opportunities. We've taken a look at all the ways people contribute and sorted them roughly into five groups. Let's take a look at each one and see whether you'll see something that resonates with you. If you're interested in or skilled with code, look at code-based contribution teams. If you have experience with PHP, HTML, JavaScript, or CSS, you'd be a great fit for these teams. If these are languages you want to learn to write, you're welcome here too. WordPress is used by seasoned and first-time developers alike, so your perspective is valuable no matter where you are in your education. On these teams, you might be asked to fix bugs, debate certain decisions, help write code, answer questions, review software, test in conjunction with different hosting environments, or use CLI, OpenVerse, or Tide to make the WordPress experience better. All you need to participate in is a local version of WordPress to test. If you're interested in or skilled with marketing and design, look at marketing-based contribution teams. If you have experience with graphic design, UX, user testing, accessible design, video production, or marketing, you'd be a great fit for these teams. Even if you don't have a ton of experience but are interested in these topics, consider joining one of these teams. These teams all focus on different things. You might be asked to help with strategy and content for other WordPress teams. You may be asked to help caption and subtitle videos on WordPress.tv. If you are interested in how people use and interact with the WordPress software, look at usability-based contribution teams. All these teams focus on how people use WordPress and its supplementary resources. For example, the accessibility team works hard to ensure that WordPress core and all WordPress resources are accessible to as many people as possible. The Polyglots team focuses on translating WordPress and helping create tools that make translations easier. If you're interested in or have experience with events and logistics, look at the community team or connect with one of your local meetups. Volunteers put on all WordPress events, and there are dozens of roles required to put on a decent event. Even if event planning isn't your style, events always need other positions filled. You might be asked to update the website or social media for the event. They may ask you to coordinate with speakers or sponsors. You may also be required to record or live stream the event. You may even just be asked to grab water and snacks. There are so many individual things that need doing. If these ways of contributing don't resonate with you, never fear. There are tons of WordPress community members who have found their own unique ways to contribute. WordPress community members are contributing new things every single day. Let's look at ways you can contribute in some unofficial ways. A WordPress podcast is a great way to contribute to the community because you can provide regular content for free that directly addresses the interests and needs of other community members. For an example, check out Kinsta's podcast, Reverse Engineered, which explores tips, tricks, and advice from industry experts in WordPress and beyond. Starting and maintaining a YouTube channel can be a full-time job, but most WordPress professionals will tell you that YouTube is one of their main sources for education when trying to learn something new. Since we're talking about YouTube here, make sure to subscribe to our channel and help us spread the word about Kinsta's YouTube channel. Even casual WordPress users need to know what's going on in the WordPress world. Newsletters are great resources to accomplish just that and keep the lifeblood of the WordPress world flowing. WordPress is all about publishing content, so using WordPress to publish content about WordPress is a great first step for newbie contributors. At Kinsta, we regularly publish WordPress-related articles. So if you haven't yet, make sure to check out our blog at kinsta.com/blog. A handful of WordPress communities out there have been created to meet specific needs. Given that the WordPress community is global, we often find that people with the same specific interests and needs gravitate to one another naturally, regardless of distance. When getting together in person isn't viable, online communities are key. Starting or helping manage an online community is a great way to give back to the WordPress community as a whole. So much of the WordPress ecosystem comprises themes, plugins, and other extensions to WordPress. Some people sell them, some distribute them for free. Regardless, complementary software to WordPress helps people all over the world to achieve their goals. And these tools can be created and distributed by anyone. Here are 5 tips we can give you to make your experience smoother and help you get the most out of contributing. It's helpful to either find a team where you can contribute skills that you already have or where you can hone in a skill that you'd like to learn. Everyone appreciates someone who walks into the room ready to tackle any challenge, and it's a good idea to have a firm idea of your limits, strengths, interests, and boundaries. While some people may have more experience contributing than others, everyone is meant to learn from everyone else. Don't be afraid to ask questions. People are volunteering their time and energy partially to help you become a better contributor. This is a must-do for some of the contributing teams. But even if your contribution is more casual, it's still a good idea to join the Make WordPress Slack group and keep an eye on what's going on. Pretty much anyone can look in on almost any public meeting, chat, or conversation. The WordPress world thrives in all sorts of places. Anywhere people using WordPress gather is a place to learn and contribute. Some popular ways to connect with the community include Twitter, Facebook groups, Slack groups, online, and in-person events. Important conversations about the past, present, and future of WordPress happen in all of these places. At the end of the day, you have to get your hands dirty. Write, design, code, break, and build with WordPress. You'll learn so much just by experimenting. It's extremely rewarding to share what you've made and learned with others. Open source is not just about sharing software, but sharing ideas. If you want to contribute to a code-based team, but feel less than confident in your coding skills, learn as you go. Don't let lack of experience hold you back. Do you have any questions left about WordPress contributions? Let us know in the comments section below. Looking for a quality local development solution? With Dev Kinsta, in a single click, you can design, develop, and deploy new WordPress projects from your local machine. Plus, it's 100% free to use, even if you aren't a Kinsta customer. Download it today at kinsta.com/devkinsta. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.